time blocks are shot, goals are out of alignment, website is trashed. Yeah, sounds like a good recipe for burnout. Well, that didn't work out too well. Took a full 2.5 days, or two, I almost did 3 days, 2.5 days to go through all of the projects that we have, all of the projects I want to do, create the not-to-do list, which if you haven't heard about that before, that's essentially just putting together a list of things that you should not do, even though you really want to do them. And then finally, with all of that, I was able to come up with time blocks. So the time jump is just to show you that this isn't something that you can just sit down and do. I definitely would like to think that I could just sit down and do it, but I've actually, over the past 2.5 days, changed the way I've done my time blocks several times. And that's also been, of course, getting feedback from my business partner and team. And then, of course, making sure that the way I structure things, I'm actually going to be available to clients and team members when I actually do need to be available. So let's go ahead and dive in. I'll show you version, I don't know, 3 or 4, and then I'll show you the final version. So the first version here, taking a look at my screen, I thought I would wake up and do my morning workout and then go ahead and spend the first part of my day recording and then go on to whatever else was going to take up the rest of my day. And so one of the things that I really like doing is in the morning, focusing on what's that one thing that's the most important. And so for me right now, that's making content, making videos, because that keeps the lights on and brings in new clients and customers. So content definitely is the most important part of how I spend my time. And so I want to make sure that that's goes on in the morning, and then the afternoon will be open to client calls or whatever. I generally, as a rule of thumb, try not to take anything before 11 a.m. because I want the best hours of my time, which is in the morning, focused on what's going to give us the highest return overall on my time, which is content. For other people on the team, it would be a different task. So jumping ahead to this next week here, I've reformatted it so you can see what the schedule I actually wound up going with. And the main reason I wound up going with this one was because I wanted to put my workouts at the end of the day, and I also wanted to move up the time I'd be available to my team, because looking at time differences, if I'm not checking in until 12 or 1 o'clock in the afternoon, a lot of people have already gone to bed. So I do need to push that up a little bit so that I'm at least awake for the last couple of work hours for some people. And then the other thing too is I wanted the workout at the end of the day because it's a really great way to relieve stress. And so I'm one of those people who likes to go to the gym or when I hit the pool, I wanna go 100%. I wanna have to go 100% and then like sit here for 7 hours and go, man, I wish I had just skipped that last interval. I'm so tired. So that's the main reason of swapping these. So we'll see how this schedule goes. It's been a really long time since I've had my schedule start this early. When I worked at a digital marketing agency, this was actually around the time I woke up, although there was a lot less stress because I wasn't running a company. I just had to show up to work, and is a whole lot different on your mental state when, you know, you don't have to be in charge of everything, when you just have to show up and do a little bit of client work. So really, just to kind of break it down, my process is very, very simple for developing these time blocks. It's figuring out what is the one thing that is most important in terms of my personal time, and then figuring out when can I do that uninterrupted. For me, that's waking up super early in the morning so I know for a fact everyone else is asleep. Actually, there are some people on my team that's the afternoon for them, but they're nice and they don't bother me, unlike clients sometimes. And then that gives me plenty of time, about 5 hours between the hours of 10 and 3, to pretty much schedule and work with whatever comes around. And so I'm purposely leaving those completely open because you never know what happens. I think this vlog is a perfect example. I thought I would sit down and do this time blocking in one day, and guess what? I got a couple client emails, I had some questions from the team, and then It took 2 days to finish this. So I sincerely hope you found this helpful. If you have any questions on how to prioritize what you're doing, like should you be focusing more on building your product or creating content or trying to get more sales calls, you know, comment below. I read and reply to every single one, as you know, and it would just be great to see kind of where you guys are looking to prioritize your daily tasks. So go ahead and hit that like button, comment below with your questions or what you prioritize as the very first thing that you want to get done in the day. And I just want to, before we go, just want to let you know that this still applies even if you still have a job. I was time blocking even when I had a full-time and part-time. It's definitely not something you can only do if you control 100% of your day. You just time block around whatever your work hours are. So until the next one, keep building the business you love.